Hello, my name is Emily. Thank you for joining me today for some yoga. For today's yoga, I'd like to show you five restorative yoga poses. Now, restorative yoga is particularly good for helping your parasympathetic nervous system to just relax and feel calm. I find that oftentimes I'm on the go, I have to-do lists, I have deadlines, and I'm always in that fight or flight spot, and so it's really nice to have some poses to go to just completely relax and let go. Now for the restorative yoga, we also use many props because the idea is to keep your body completely supported so that your muscles don't have to work at all and then you're just fully able to relax into the position. Furthermore, these positions are held for anywhere from 3 minutes to over 10 minutes. And I think for the purposes of this yoga, we'll hold each pose for about 3 breaths, but then feel free to string them together in any sequence that you'd like for any length that you'd like. So to get started, go ahead and gather up some props. I have 2 pillows here, 2 towels, 2 blocks. Feel free to grab some blankets and fold them so that you can stack them easily. It's nice to make a little bit of height to hold your body where it feels good for you. So let's take a moment to get some of those props together. And then let's get started with just a quiet moment. So we'll come into a comfortable seated position. Let's imagine that there's a cord extending from the crown of your head to the sky. Drop your chin slightly. If it feels good, bring your eyes to a close. Bringing your attention into the room, focusing on any sounds. Letting go of any thoughts. And then bringing your attention into your body and connecting with your breath. Inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the mouth. And take a moment to think about an intention you'd like to invite into your practice or perhaps even into your life in this new year. Perhaps peace, relaxation, joy, whatever it is you'd like to focus on. When you're ready, gently bring your eyes open. So to get started with, let's start with a supported child's pose. So for this one, I have a stack of 2 pillows. And that will be to support my chest. Now if I find that I need support in my knees or behind my knees, I can use a blanket or a towel to do so. So for this, let's come onto our knees, bringing the pillows close. And for a child's pose, let's bring our legs open, toes are together. So this is where I put the pillow right here, under my knees, right on my heel, so that it supports me a little more. And I'll inhale here. And on the exhale, let's lean forward, bringing our fingers to the ground, bringing our body onto the pillow. This is a great stretch for just releasing tension in the back. Feel free to bring your head to either side. Connecting with your breath and sinking into the posture, just letting your props hold you and support you. You may need to experiment to find just the right height for you. So inhaling here. On the exhale, use your hands to help bring you into a seated position.
from here,
I'm turning my body and grabbing a few more props for supported butterfly pose or cobbler's pose. This is called Supta Bodhakonasana. The Supta is reclined and Bodhakonasana is bound cobbler's pose. So I like to start with more height to support my knees. And then I find that if it's too much height, I can always take some of this away. So I have a block and a towel on either side of my legs. My hips are up against my pillow. I'm going to inhale here and just recline gently. Getting a comfortable position here. My knees are bent, pointing towards the sky. My toes are together. Inhaling here and slightly dropping my knees. You can adjust the props to catch you and support you in the best possible way. Hands can come out to your side, perhaps in a T shape. If it's more comfortable, they can stay on your stomach. It's completely what feels good for you and your body. And again, restorative yoga is just about relaxing and sinking deeper and deeper into the pose and allowing the props to help you do that. Let's connect with our breath, breathing through our nose and out through our mouth. And when you're ready, we'll guide our knees to point towards the ceiling, dropping the hands on the floor and rolling over onto the side. You can use your hands to help push you into a seated position. My next posture, while I'm sitting right here, I'd like to do a supported spinal twist. So as I'm sitting here, my hip is pushed up against my pillow. My bottom knee is close to the pillow. And my top knee is splayed out slightly. On my inhale, finding length through the spine. And on the exhale, twisting over the pillows, starting with my belly button, so moving belly first, neck last, and then using my hands to guide me down to a comfortable position. Feel free to add more height here. Perhaps it'd be more comfortable being up a little higher. Hands down to the side, and just allowing your body to sink into this position. Feeling completely supported and comfortable. If at any time it's uncomfortable, feel free to come out of the position and modify it, or feel free to skip it. Connecting with the breath, breathing through the nose. Inhale, bringing our hands back, and on the exhale, push our body up, and then we'll gently move over to the other side. So now, my opposite hip is pushed up against my pillows, my bottom knee is closest to my pillows, while my top knee is splayed out slightly. On the inhale, find some length through the spine. And on the exhale, starting with the belly button, we'll turn, head coming last, hands coming down to the floor, and guiding your body down into a comfortable position. Relaxing your body, making any necessary adjustments, and connecting with your breath. On the inhale, let's bring our hands back. And on the exhale, we'll guide our body into a seated position. The next position is a supported fish pose. And for this, let's bring our hips up against the pillow. If it feels good, you can feel free. We'll put a towel under your knees. Let's inhale, coming up into it. Bringing some length into our spine, and then exhale, walking the hands back, guiding your body into a comfortable position, opening up through the chest, through the heart, through the shoulders. Hands can come out into a T, or perhaps at about a 45 degree angle from your body, or even on your belly. Sinking here, letting the pillows just catch your body, cradle your body. And from here, let's roll over onto your side and push yourself up into a comfortable position. Now for closing, I'd like to show you legs up the wall or Shavasana. You can choose whichever one's best for you. For Shavasana, I actually like to take some of the arch out of my shoulders. So I have a pillow for my head. I have a pillow for my knee, or excuse me, a towel for under my knees. And for Shavasana, your final resting pose. Feel free to guide yourself down. You can feel free to put a towel under your lower back. That would help catch and support you. Hands come out to the side, toes are splayed out to the side, and just sinking into the position. So this is one of the final resting poses. Another option is doing legs up the wall. And for this, so many props. For this, I like to have a towel under my head, or perhaps a pillow under your head would feel better, whichever you prefer. And I bring my hips right to the wall, and then guide my body into a reclined position. From here, I bring my legs up, and then I shimmy my body around. My head's on the towel. If it feels good, feel free to put a towel under your hips, raise your hips a little bit. Again, you can bring your body, your arms out into the T, or perhaps your hands are on your belly, whichever feels best for you. You can sink into this position, or perhaps you're in Shavasana. You can gently close your eyes. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. Now from here, let's gently bring our legs down, shimmying our body around to the side, perhaps removing any prompts that you may have. Let's roll over onto the side and push yourself up into a comfortable seated position. Let's sit up tall, again bringing an imaginary rope extending from the crown of our head to the sky, dropping the chin. Let's take one deep breath together through the nose and out through the mouth. Let's inhale, bringing the hands up over the head, and palms come in front of the heart. May you move throughout this year. Peace, relaxation, and joy. Namaste. Thank you for joining me today.